Dear students, today let us discuss about average fixed cost, average variable cost as well as average cost. First of all, talking about average fixed cost. Average fixed cost is the fixed cost per unit of output. That means in order to produce one unit, how much of fixed cost has been incurred, it is said to be average fixed cost. Formula for finding average fixed cost is given over here. AFC is equals to TFC upon TP. That means average fixed cost is equals to total fixed cost divided by total production. That means by dividing the total fixed cost with production units, we get average fixed cost. When production increases, the total fixed cost is distributed among more units, and therefore average fixed cost curve is a downward sloping curve. Say for example, when 10 units are produced and if total fixed cost is rupees 100, then average fixed cost would be rupees 10. But when 20 units are produced and fixed cost is rupees 100, so this average fixed cost now reduces to rupees 5. And similarly, when production is increased to 50 units and total fixed cost is rupees 100, so this average fixed cost is reduced to rupees 2. That means with every increase in production, average fixed cost decreases. So, however, average fixed cost decreases, but it never becomes zero. Talking about average variable cost, just like average fixed cost, average variable cost is also the variable cost per unit of output. So that means in order to produce one unit, how much of variable cost has been incurred is known to be average variable cost. Here also formula is given over here. AVC is equals to TVC upon TP. That means average variable cost is equals to total variable cost divided by total production. That means when we divide total variable cost of a firm by total units produced, we get average variable cost. Initially, with the increase in production, average variable cost decreases. Okay, just because of the same reason what we have studied, that due to increasing return to scale, with an increase in production, average variable cost initially decreases. Then it becomes minimum, and after that, again due to decreasing return to scale law, with an increase in production, average variable cost also increases. Now finally, talking about average cost. Average cost is also known as average total cost. Average cost is cost per unit of output. That means in order to produce one unit, how much of total cost has been incurred, that is said to be average cost. Formula is average cost is equals to total cost upon total production, or AC is equals to TC by TP. That means whatever is the total cost, as we know that total cost is a sum of total fixed cost and total variable cost. So whatever is the total cost, when this total cost is divided by total production, then we get average cost. Here also, initially with an increase in production, average cost decreases, then it becomes minimum, and after that it increases with an increase in production. And this is one of the reason why the shape of average cost curve is U, capital alphabet U. Again, one hypothetical example has been given over here. As seen, production, total cost and average cost has been given over here. So as we know that as production increases, total cost also increases, and in order to find out average cost, this total cost is divided by production. When one unit was produced, total cost was rupees 9. So when 9 is divided by 1, average cost is equals to 9. Similarly, when 2 units are produced, total cost is 16. So 16 divided by 2, average cost is 8. In the same manner, the average cost for all the units has been found out over here. And now when this trend of average cost is plotted in a diagram, then this kind of diagram is cooked in. As you can see over here, on x-axis units of output, and on y-axis average cost has been given over here. And as said earlier, that initially with an increase in production the average cost decreases, then at a particular level, see at the third and fourth unit, it has attained its minimum level, and especially after fourth unit, with an increase in production, average cost also increases, and this is one of the reason why average cost curve becomes U-shaped. Thank you, students.